Hello, welcome to Let Us Mouse Basic Sets online tutorials. Today's tutorial is on English language, taken from strand 3, grammar usage at word and phrase level. Sub strand 2, determinants, indicator 1. Identify and use definite and indefinite articles. You are to identify and use definite and indefinite articles. Today's lesson is on determinants. And before we look at examples of determinants, let's ask ourselves, what is a determinant? What is a determinant? Determinants, they are words used to introduce a noun in a sentence. They are words used to introduce a noun in a sentence. Words are found in sentences, and before every noun, there is a determinant. Now, let's look at examples of determinants. We have a whole lot of determinants, but with your level, we are going to look at 4 types of determinants. Examples, we have articles, and examples of articles are a, an, and the. We also have quantifiers, examples are some, few, little, many, etc. We have a whole lot of quantifiers. We also have demonstratives. We have that, this, those, and these. We also have possessives. They are all determinants. Examples of possessives are mine, yours, hers, theirs, etc. We have a whole lot of them. But in today's lesson, we are going to look at the articles. The articles. And with articles, we have a, an, and they. But in today's lesson, with the articles, we are going to look at the use of a, an. Let's start with the definite articles a and an. With the articles, we also have definite and indefinite articles. The definite articles are a and an. And the indefinite article is the. So today we are going to look at the definite articles, which are a and an. Definite articles show general version of a noun. Definite articles show general version of a noun. That is nouns in general. All nouns in general use the word a. You should note that nouns that begins with a consonant always begin with a definite article a. Now let's look at some of the uses of a. A. The use of a. It is used to point out a person, animal, or being in an ordinary or common sense. A is used to point out a person, animal, or being in an ordinary or common sense. Let's look at example of some of the ordinary or common nouns that use a. Example, a lion, a girl, a visitor, etc. All these are common nouns that use a before those nouns in a sentence. A is also used before a proper noun to change it into a common noun. In our previous lessons, common noun. Let's look at this example of how it has been used in a sentence. Asantes ni eya santua again. Asantes ni eya santua again. Ya santua is a proper noun, but e is used in front of ya santua, which is a proper noun, to change it into a common noun. Let's look at example two. We are looking for a Solomon again. We are looking for a Solomon again. Solomon here is a name of a person and also a proper noun. So a is used in place of this proper noun to make it a common noun. Let's look at another way that a is also used again. It is used to denote a whole class. It is used to denote a whole class. When we say a whole class, we are talking about a number of things, but one word is used in place of them. Like a donkey can be used in a sentence to represent all donkeys, but it will be written only donkey without S, representing a whole class. Let's look at an example on the board. A donkey is a stupid animal. A donkey is a stupid animal. The donkey here is singular, but it is plural. That is why a is used at the beginning of this donkey, which represents a whole class of donkeys. So a donkey is a stupid animal means all donkeys are stupid. But the donkey here is used in place of all donkeys. Let's look at another example again. A dog runs away if you hold a stone. A dog runs away if you hold a stone. Dog here is singular, but it is plural because of the A in front of it. A dog stands in for all dogs in the whole world. Any dog that sees you holding a stone will run away. But because of the A here, we use only dog. We didn't say dogs. A dog runs away. So a dog here stands in place of all dogs. So it is standing in place for a whole class of what? Dogs. Let's look at the an. The an, which is another type of a definite article. An is used if the first letter of the noun in a sentence happens to be a vowel. An is used if the first letter of the noun in a sentence happens to be a vowel. With the letters of the alphabet, we have vowels and consonants. And we know the vowels. We have five vowels within the alphabet. You have A, E, I, O, U. Those are the vowels. So all nouns that begin with a vowel takes an before that noun. So let's look at example. Let's look at examples of them. An orange. An orange. Orange starts with O. It is a vowel. So we don't say an orange, we say an orange. An umbrella. U is a vowel. So we say an umbrella. Apple. A is what? A vowel. So we say an apple. We don't say an apple. It is wrong. So all nouns in sentences that begins with a vowel, we use an in front of them. So let's go to the board and look at a few examples of how to use a or an. Example one, put in a or an. I saw dash monkey on a tree at the zoo. Monkey is a noun. The noun in this sentence is monkey. Monkey begins with a consonant, so we have to put in a. So I saw a monkey on the tree at the zoo. Let's look at example two. Africans need dash Mandela is a name of a person. It is also a proper noun. So we use a. So it becomes Africans need a Mandela to rule again, to make this proper noun a common noun. 3, we use that umbrella when it rained last night. We use dash umbrella when it rained last night. The noun in this sentence is umbrella. An umbrella is a common noun already, but it begins with you, and you is a vowel. So vowel goes with an. So we use an umbrella when it rained last night, because the umbrella here begins with you, which is a vowel. Let's look at question 4. Dash cheetah is the fastest animal in the world. The noun here is cheetah. But when you look at the sentence, cheetah here is standing in for a whole class of cheetahs. So we use a cheetah is the fastest animal in the world. Let's look at the last question. There was dash old lady in the temple. There was dash old lady in the temple. The lady here with the preposition old is the noun in this sentence. So because of the old is a vowel. So vowel begins with what? And. So there was an old lady in the temple. So children, below these tutorials, I will upload these questions, download and answer them, and we'll meet again in our next tutorial. Keep on practicing and subscribe to our YouTube channel. Bye-bye.